Now to a Target 5 investigation tonight. They were brides for hire. Tri-state women paid thousands of dollars to marry Russian men looking for an easy road to U.S. citizenship.
Yeah, but now the men have skipped town, leaving their so-called wives stuck in marriages with no idea of how to get a divorce. Target 5's Eric Flack has more on what these Russian brides are now calling the biggest mistakes of their lives.
When Target 5 first broke the story of these Russian brides more than a year ago, the women told us they saw the arrangement as a way to make some easy money. They now tell us the deal has been anything but happily ever after.
We are gathered here together.
Their wedding day was payday.
I was scared, but it was money, so I did it.
West End women, down on their luck, offered a quick buck to marry Russian men looking for a way to stay in the U.S. As Target 5 found when it first reported this story last year, the newlyweds often go their separate ways within minutes of tying the knot.
And what did they say the purpose was?
To help him get a green card.
But 2 years after these two Price Hill women married Russian men for money, they say their husbands have disappeared.
And now I'm pretty much stuck married and I'm in a rock and a hard spot because I can't get out of it.
Bound by a union based in a lie.
I didn't know him. I still don't know him. Still to this day, I don't know him.
This woman, who we will call Lindsay, last saw her husband in December of 2006. Her friend, who we will call Nicole, last saw the man she married in May of 2007. Both were paid $700 up front and $300 a month after that to marry Russians they had never met before so they could become U.S. citizens. But after they got married to get a green card, the Russians needed their new brides to lie to U.S. immigration investigators. After seeing our original report, the women backed out of that meeting with immigration.
He asked me several times, and I would not go, because when I saw the story on the news, I flipped out.
Scared not only about the possibility of going to jail, but also about potential ties between the arranged marriages and the Russian mob. So with no other use for the women, their new husbands took off.
They're pretty much having their time in their life here because they can run and they can do what they want because they're still married to us and we can't find them to get a divorce.
Without their husbands around to sign divorce papers, the women will face a long, costly, and embarrassing battle to end their marriages. They will need to file a public notice of divorce in the newspaper, wait months for that notice to become official, then spend $1,000 or more in filing fees and lawyer bills. The women, who stopped getting paid the moment they stopped going along with the plan, say they don't have that kind of money. They spent their wedding cash long ago. Getting paid to say I do, possibly costing them the chance to really mean it.
One of these days when I do find the right man and I want to go and marry him, I won't be able to marry that guy because I'm still married to a Russian.
If there is good news for the women we spoke with, it's that because they stopped cooperating before they lied to immigration, they have not broken any laws. They continue to try and track down their husbands so they can get the divorces that will bring an end to what they now agree was a terrible mistake. Eric Flack, Target 5.